Myself Gunashekar Dorji. I'm working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department. Today we will be discussing regarding casting process. So if we come to the casting process, casting is one of the oldest manufacturing process. Now if we see manufacturing, there are four different classifications in the manufacturing process. One is casting, second one is forming, third one is welding, and the fourth one is the machining. So basically casting and metal forming comes under primary manufacturing process, whereas machining and welding will come under the secondary manufacturing process. So in this context, today we will be discussing regarding the casting. As I have told you, it is one of the oldest manufacturing process. So what exactly happens in the casting? In casting, the material is first liquefied by melting in a suitable furnace. Thereafter, the liquefied metal is poured into any molded cavity where the pattern will be having the replica of the shape. Then after the pouring the molten metal into the mold cavity, we'll break the mold cavity and we will allow it to solidify. Then we'll break the mold cavity and remove the component, and then we'll do any further machining operations. So this is basically about casting. In casting, there are different types of classifications in casting. The primary one is the expandable mold casting, or else it is called as also temporary mold casting. And the secondary one is the permanent mold casting. If you clearly observe, there is only minute difference between the expandable or permanent temporary and the permanent mold casting. The thing is, in expandable mold casting, we will change the mold each and every time. And in permanent mold casting, the mold is constant, and that is with the help of a single mold, we can manufacture number of components or the patterns. So basically in expandable mold casting, we are having permanent sand casting or expandable pattern, that is investment casting. And in permanent casting, again we are having semi-permanent core or permanent core, or else you can call permanent metal casting also as a die casting. In expandable mold casting, we will be preparing it with the help of a sand. So in today's context, we will be discussing mainly regarding the sand casting, or else it is also called as the expandable mold casting. Why expandable mold casting? Because we are using the sand as the primary ingredient, where we'll be changing the sand for each and every manufacturing of a component. So if at all we look into the steps involved in the casting, basically there will be 5 steps. First one is the preparation of the pattern, or else it is also called as the pattern making. Pattern is nothing but a negative. If you go to any photo studio, we'll be taking a picture, right? In olden days, there used to be normal cameras where we'll be using real type of cameras. So if we take any photograph, the photograph person will be giving us a negative. With the help of negative, we can take how many pics we want, we can take it as a print. Similarly, in casting also, pattern is nothing but a negative. With that help of pattern, we can manufacture number of components by keeping that pattern into a mold. So the first step is nothing but the pattern making. The second one is preparation of the mold. The mold will be prepared with the help of the pattern and some other materials like sand, binding agents, so that the pattern get the required strength. Next, after preparation the mold, the third step is nothing but the melting and pouring of the liquefied metal. So whatever the material we require for the end component usage, first we have to take that material or extract that material. Then we have to melt that material in a suitable furnaces. There are many types of furnaces available widely in the market. So after melting that material, then we have to bring that liquefied material into the mold cavity and then pour that liquefied material into the mold cavity. So this comes up to the third step. Then fourth step is nothing but once we have poured that liquefied metal into the mold cavity, the liquefied metal needs to get solidified. That is, it will be taking certain time to solidify. So basically, any metal which is heated, it will be undergoing a different transition status. Then after heating, once we cool, again it will be coming back to its original position. So once it is solidified to the room temperature, then the final step is we have to break the mold and remove the component after breaking the mold. After removing the component cannot directly be used in the end use application, because casting is one of the oldest manufacturing process and it contains a lot of surface irregularities or defects. As I told you, casting is the primary manufacturing process. That is, if at all you want to manufacture a component, in the initial stages, the manufacturing component suppose starts with A and end with B, then the initial stages may be B and C. So if at all you want to manufacture a component. So first you have to go for the stage A. So stage A is nothing but the casting process, where there may be a lot of irregularities. So in order to remove any type of irregularities, further the component has to undergo the secondary manufacturing process. As I have told you, the secondary manufacturing process may be either machining or welding. Depending upon our applications, we'll be going for the different process. So in casting, the component cannot be directly manufactured.